Hello guys, I'm Evelyn and welcome to my channel. I hope you're all having a wonderful day. So, today we are building a house that is mainly for a gardener or a gardener and their family. It has been requested quite a few times by now, so I thought the other day after, I don't actually remember what I was doing on the day, but in the evening I was just like, you know what, I just want to sit down. I don't want to like continue one of the work in progresses that I currently have, even though I do like all of them, so they will be coming up on the channel at some point. But I read a comment on one of my videos, I don't remember which one, and someone had asked if I could do a gardener's home or just like a home that was more that was meant for a gardener, I guess you could say. And I thought, yeah, I kind of want to do that, so I sat down and started doing that instead. And this is the outcome. It's sort of like a storybook cottage. It is inspired by a picture I saw on Pinterest, just because, I don't know, I like to get inspiration for my builds. I think it was a cottage, sort of, the building that I'm thinking of, or the building that I took inspiration from. I think it was a cottage. I put this little bit here on the left, which is sort of like a modern extension. It does not stay two levels, I did the upper floor, so it's just one level. And I put the dining area in there, so that's all good. But yeah, other than that, it's just like an old kind of Tudor-ish, storybook kind of cottage-ish kind of thing. And with that little modern extension over there, and also a little gardening area to the right of the build. And then a whole lot of plants outside, mainly flowers, because I just felt like going crazy with the flowers. I wanted the exterior to be, or the landscaping to be, very cute. So yeah, a lot of flowers, because I feel like whenever you want to make cute landscaping, you need a whole lot of flowers for that. I think I went for mainly yellow, no, not yellow, white and pink, maybe a little bit of yellow, but mainly white and pink, if I'm not mistaken. Even though it kind of like, I don't know, I feel like pink looks a little bit weird when the cottage looks a little bit older. So, but it works in this case, in my opinion at least. And I don't know why I feel like that. It's just one of those things, I guess, that you associate pink flowers with more like suburban houses, I guess. I don't fully know what that's about, but that's just my mind. Anyways, so that is what we're doing today, and I hope you guys really, really like this build. I had a lot of fun doing it, and I basically just like, I started one evening and then I finished it the evening after, so I did not take a lot of breaks during this. I didn't continue another build in the middle of this. I basically just focused on getting this build done. But yeah, tonight I will hopefully have time to do some more building. I have a tiny job that I need to do for tomorrow. Other than that, I think I'm just gonna prepare videos for the next week. I do have a lot of plans for the channel, and I don't know, I get these like spurts of motivation. Does that make any sense? Spurts. Maybe we should call it waves instead, waves of motivation. Yeah, I get a lot of those, and not that I'm ever completely demotivated when it comes to my channel, because I'm really not. Like, I always love making videos, but I do get these kind of periods of time where I'm just even more motivated, and I feel like that right now, and it's kind of awkward timing because I'm also busy with other stuff. But yeah, that's just how it is, I guess. But I'm really, really motivated, so tonight I am gonna sit down and just record a lot of videos. So let me know if there's anything you want to see. I can't record anything in real time, but I will be building or preparing cast videos and stuff like that, so I can't do anything that requires me to do commentary live, because, or real-time commentary, because my boyfriend will be in the room right next to me, and I can't deal with it. So you guys know this by now if you watched my videos. I don't like recording when he's here, so that is just how that is. But he is going back to work tomorrow, so from tomorrow on I'll have lots of time to do those kind of videos again, and I am looking forward to that as well. Even though it is nice that he's home, I just also prefer, like, I don't know, not prefer, but I also like to just sit here and relax and do my commentaries or voiceovers or whatever I do. So yeah, I'm looking forward to that a little bit, but again, it's gonna be lonely being home alone all day, I guess. This house is for two parents and also a kid. I didn't make the kids' room too gender specific, in my opinion. So you could either have a boy or a girl living in there, and you could possibly also So remove a few things and add a few other things, and then you could turn it into a teen's room instead, because it's not like there are a lot of toys in there, but I wouldn't say that it's overly like kid. Does that make any sense? But anyways, no matter what you do, you can always like do whatever you want with my builds. All I'm asking for is that you don't re-upload it. That is literally everything. But yeah, so two parents and a kid, and that is pretty much about it. It is not the biggest family home. As you can see, it's not the biggest exterior either. I mean, it's not the biggest house. It's basically what I mean, but I just can't English. But yeah, they also have a living room, which is fairly big, which with a little study area, and they also have an actual study. I think I put in a kind of like a hobby room, but they don't really have a lot of like hobby things in there. I don't remember if I put an easel in there. Maybe I did, but they do have a computer in there along with a computer. Actually, they have a surprising amount of computers in this house, considering it's for a gardener. But I don't know. I feel like it's easier to play the game if you have a computer in the like in your house in the game, if that makes any sense. Like I feel like it's a necessity almost for the sim, but I could be wrong. Maybe that's just my play style that's something wrong with. Wouldn't surprise me considering how much time I spend behind my computer every day. But yeah, so they do have two computers at least, and they also have in the study there is a little sitting area and also a bookcase, and then they have a kitchen with a dining area as well. And I really like how the kitchen turned out. I'm using the parenthood counters again, surprise, but it's okay. We've come to the conclusion by now that that's just, I have an addiction to those counters. I need them in my games, or not my games, I need them in my builds, and that's just how that is by now. It's just, I love them, they are so nice. So until we get some that are just as versatile as those ones, I will probably continue using them along with the Jungle Adventure ones, because I really like those too. But yeah, for now we're just continuing the parenthood ones. But I'm actually spending a lot of time with the exterior of this build before I start the interior, because as you can see, there isn't much of a backyard in this build. I thought that would be okay considering the house is in Windenburg in the very foresty kind of area, so they do have a lot of landscaping around, or a lot of nature around the build, so I thought that would be okay. Also considering you can now put in, I think I've been able to do this for about 3 weeks or something, but we did get a patch which lets our sim, or there was an update which basically means that our sims can carry easels outside of the lot. So what they can do is take an easel and they can go into the nature and paint in there, and I think that's super cute. So they don't have a swing or, you know, anything else like that. They don't have a sitting area outside. You can definitely put in a table instead of the fireplace right here, but I just thought the little fireplace would be cute. I don't actually know if it's called a fire pit maybe. I don't freaking know, but they can do that instead. You can just put like a table in instead, and they can sit outside and eat if you want to. But the little modern extension where the dining area is actually really nice, because it's just surrounded by trees and greenery, and there's a nice view over the hills in the background as well. So there is that. It will almost look like they're sitting outside, except if it's raining they won't actually get wet, they'll just sit under the glass roof. So there's that. But if you do insist on having your sim sit outside, like I said, you can do whatever, like down in this little side yard area. If you don't like playing with laundry as well, just remove that clothesline and the tub, whatever, and also the laundry bags. They're not laundry bags, but laundry boxes. I don't actually know, there's a specific word for it. Hamper, I don't freaking know what it is, but you probably know what I'm talking about. And you can just remove that from the bathroom on the upper floor, and then laundry will be taken out of this build as a whole, and you can just enjoy laundry free gameplay. I mean, I've actually gotten a few comments from people saying they actually play with laundry, but I know for a fact that there are a lot of people that enjoyed it for the first couple weeks, myself included, and then just kind of like, it's not that much fun anymore. It's just like a little bit like a nuisance kind of. Is that how you pronounce that word? I know how to spell it. Do you guys ever get that? There are a lot of words that you know how to spell, but you've never heard them been pronounced before, so you're not entirely sure how to say it. That's one of those words for me. I have a lot of those, to be honest, because I used to chat a lot in English, not say it, so, like not talk it very much, because because obviously I've lived in Denmark, so why would I be speaking English to my friends? So I used to chat a lot in English and I got a big vocabulary like that, but I have no idea how to pronounce half of those words. Like, what do I do? But it's one of those words, but hopefully I didn't fail at the pronunciation. We are also using a few items from the new update or the free content update that we got Thursday, including that coffee table, which I freaking love. I love that there are a few swatches that are just completely simple, so you can use them in more modern environments maybe, or interiors, but there's also those that are a little bit more special. This one, I feel like it's simple enough that it could still work in a suburban house, but you could definitely, like, I want to say dress it up, but that's more of a clothing kind of context, but hopefully you get what I mean. Like, you can just, like, kind of dress it up still, so it looks a little bit more bohemian sort of as well. But I do love that table also because I have been wanting a round coffee table that takes up 4 squares, and that one is almost round. It's an octagon, so I think it counts. I'm okay with it, like octagon or round, I'm completely fine with it. So yes, I'm so happy we got that because it's not a freaking square, and yes, I just love it. And I also really like the swatches of it. The wallpaper is also new. It's one of the simple, or it's the plain version of the leafy wallpaper that we also got Thursday, and I really like the leafy, or I really like the leafy swatches as well, but I actually really love the colors that we got for the plain swatches or the solid swatches. I don't, you know what I mean. So this one is more of like a, it kind of has like a pink touch to it, or like a slight peach pink kind of touch to it. At least it's like what it looks like in my game. I also have reshade on, so I'm not entirely sure, but I think it is like a kind of like a pink touch kind of color. So yeah, I really like that one, and I'm definitely really happy with that one. I still wish we got the leafy wallpaper with just like leaf from top to floor, but we didn't, not this time around. I am pretty sure that someone's gonna make CC from that and just make like a completely leaf wallpaper, but I don't use build CC, you guys know this, so I'm still gonna just use the other ones, I guess. But I do love them still, despite like still wanting a full like leaf wallpaper. I do like the other ones with the wooden panels as well, so yes, so happy with that. This is the living room, in case you hadn't noticed yet. I think it is the first time I use a swatch of that couch. I'm pretty sure I used the more lighter green one in my spring apartment and also in my spring family home, but I do really like that more darker kind of swatch as well. It has a really, really nice color, and we're again using the Seasons couch in the little study room in here, just in the lavender one, because okay, purple is my favorite color. If black was the color, that would be my favorite color, but it's not, so purple is my favorite color along with burgundy. I am obsessed with those. I could, yes, I could live in that. So when I saw that those couches had both purple and this more like, it's kind of like a lavendery kind of color, it's a little bit of like a lighter purple, they have two purples, I was dead. I was so happy because they're just, I love them. So yes, so happy with that. Also because I feel like, or I'm pretty sure that 2 weeks before we got the Seasons expansion pack, or it might have been like a month before or something, but I sat here doing a voiceover because I made a suburban house which had very purple kind of interior, and I was so frustrated doing that interior because we didn't have a lot of purple, and it's my favorite color, and I want that in my game. So when I saw those couches have purple swatches, I squealed, and I was so happy. So yeah, I do overuse that couch just a little bit, but I do love it so much. I feel like it's very versatile, and I really like the swatches as well. So yes, I do overuse that couch, I am aware, but I really love it, so I hope you guys are okay with it. This is the dining area that I was talking about before. I don't actually think you can probably see the view from the dining table during filming, but it is definitely shown in the screenshots at the end of the video, so just keep that in mind. But they do have like a very, very nice little view over the nature from the dining table, so I thought that was really, really, I thought that was cool, because I would love to just, I'm not a very naturey person, I would not want to go out into nature. I've talked about this before, I have terrible arachnophobia. I just don't like no, that's part of the reason, but also because I don't want to mess up my shoes. But, I mean, I technically have boots that I could wear outside, but I just don't, it's not, I'm fine with just going for a walk through the city, I'm good with that. I know my mom doesn't get it, her her and also my brother love to go for walks in the forest, but I just know it's not really, nope. So whenever I'm in Dilburg and they're like, oh, come on, you should go for a walk with us in the forest. I'm like, no, I don't want to. There are spiders everywhere. We actually had like, we had an incident the other night because I went to bed quite late the other day. Surprise, whatever. So, and then I went to the bathroom. When I got out from the bathroom, there was these, because they have these like really big spiders over here, much bigger than in Denmark, and Danish spiders seem small to me now, considering how big they are over here. I don't fully get it, and I'm pretty sure they're not like overly big considering like worldwide, but that's just whatever. It was huge, and it was just sitting chilling on the wall. It was not moving, and I just froze. Like, I think I ran to my room, and then I turned around, stared at it, and I just froze. Like, I did not know what to do, because I can't fall asleep knowing that there's a spider. As long as I don't know that there's a spider, I'm okay. But as soon as I've seen it, I need it gone before I can relax again. So I was staring at it, like, because I couldn't fully see its legs, and as soon as I can see its legs, that's when I freak out completely. I don't know why it works like that, just does for me. And I was just standing there in the doorway like, what do I do? It took me 10 minutes to wake up my boyfriend, like, could you just remove it? And apparently he didn't like it either. So man, because it was really, really big, and he squashed it with a magazine, and then he wanted me to pick it up afterwards, the magazine, and I froze again. I started crying, I was shaking, I got like, my heart started fluttering. I just, no, it was not working out. I was sweating as well. I was having a meltdown. So no, spiders in the forest, not my thing. I'll stay inside or go for a walk in the city. But getting back to the point, I wouldn't mind sitting in a dining room with a view like that, just eating, chilling with the family or something like that. My dad has a dining room which has a nice view over some hills, because we don't really have mountains in Denmark. But it is nice to sit there and chill and just like look out the window or talk to each other or whatever. So yeah, I do like that little dining area they have down there with the view. I think I managed to completely talk over the parents' bedroom, but for both the bedrooms, I was trying to go for a very light brown for the woods, and then also green, because when I think of gardeners, I think of plants, and plants are green, so there you go. I also gave them the paintings from, where were they from? Was it, not Seasons, Cats and Dogs maybe? They have these like, it's the one with the five different motifs. You get them in like five different swatches, so you got white, green, blue, brown, and there's a fifth one, or are there only four different colors? I don't fully remember, but I really like those. I like that they're more graphic, they're not, you know, specific, they're more abstract. I really like that. But they do have, one of the swatches is a little bit different from the others, or one of the color schemes is a little bit different from the others. It's the green one, because it has sort of, it has white in it as well as also a little bit of blue, and it just reminds me of outdoors. Like, I don't fully know why, it just does. Like, the green is kind of like grass, the white are like clouds, and then the blue sky, I don't know. But I feel like those fit well in there, along with the cats and dogs bed as well, and just like trying to clutter up everything but without making it overly cluttered. And I really love those, I have no idea what those are called, the wall, not wall decor, the things you can see right now that are hanging from the ceiling. I have no idea what those are called, but I love them. They kind of remind me of Christmas a little bit, because we used to put those on our Christmas tree, but it's whatever, they are a different swatch. That swatch or those colors do not remind me of Christmas, so I think it's okay. But yeah, definitely overall for both of the bedrooms, trying to go for more like a summery feel, very light, very happy, and cluttered. Clutter is important. I love my clutter. But anyways, guys, let me know how you guys are doing today on this Sunday. Have you been sleeping in? Are you preparing for school tomorrow or work, or what are you doing? How is your day? Just let me know in the comment section down below. I think we are getting to the end of the build, so I'm gonna wrap up this voiceover now. Do let me know in the comment section as well if you do have any suggestions to builds you want to see here on the channel, or create a sim challenges. I will be starting up my Runaway Teen Let's Play again, so don't worry about that. I did get a few questions about it or some comments on the last episode, but it will be starting up again, so I don't know if those people are even watching this video, but if they are, hey, hello. The LP is starting up again, so don't worry. But yeah, just let me know if you got any creative sim videos you want to see, or speed builds, or whatever. Just let me know in the comment section down below. But anyways, I hope you like this build. You can download it off the gallery. My ID is EvelynYT, and you can also find it under the hashtag Evelyn or EvelynYT, and all the name and size slot or lot size and price and everything is listed in the description down below as always. And other than that, I hope you enjoyed this video. Remember to like, subscribe, and all that good stuff if you did, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye bye.
When everything is on, we light a candle. We're breathing really slow with artists. We're waiting for the dawn with empty bottles. You turn around when I wanna kiss. I try to reach you, but that's nothing new. I kinda know, cause you turn around when I wanna kiss. November, but you turn around when I